Welcome to Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. Well, this month I've been doing some work on my shed, having to replace two sides of the shed due to the age and the weather. The shed is over 35 years old, so I was using my screwdriver and my nails and hammer gun a lot, and I found that this screwdriver bit that you fit into an electric drill wasn't holding the screws as well as it used to, and sometimes it would round the inside of the screw off so you couldn't get a good drive on the screw. So I wondered whether you can sharpen these up and reuse them. I've already thrown one in the dustbin, which I've retrieved, and we're going to sharpen one of these up and see whether we can reuse it. So let's go into the workshop, see how we do it. I've been doing some work on the shed and I've replaced the front and the side of the shed. The door is now on the side. Originally it was on the front. And this, as you can see, is a side that gets the most sun. So all the wood on these two sides has been replaced because it was all warped and dried out in the summer and soaky wet in the winter. So I've replaced all the wood, repainted it. I noticed that my screwdriver was slipping. So this is what I've been using for the screws. A double-ended screwdriver that fits in an electric drill. These are super screws. I found that when they first had this screwdriver attachment, this double-ended screwdriver, it was really good. And over the years, I've noticed that it started to slip. Once the screw head's been damaged, it slips even more. And I noticed that the edges on the screwdriver had been taken off, and I think that's why it slips. So I was wondering whether I could sharpen this up to give a nice sharp edge so that it doesn't slip as much in the screw. Now if you look at the edge of the screwdriver under the microscope, let's get this in focus. You can see where it hasn't come into contact with the screw, the edge is quite sharp here, and where the screw has come into contact, it's taken the edge of the screwdriver away. And once that edge goes, the screwdriver slips more, so it starts slipping. The more you use it, the more it slips. So I was looking at this the other day and I thought, oh, I wonder if we can sharpen that in any way by taking some off this edge and moving the whole of the screwdriver down so it starts operating on the unused part here. So I don't know whether it will sharpen up or whether it will work, but I was going to throw it away, so I thought I'll have a go just in case I could save it and use it for another few months. So I've come over to the tool cutter grinder. I still have the attachment on that I used for sharpening some drills up a few days ago, and it's still set for drill sharpening. So what I want to do is find a collet that will fit the screwdriver a bit so I can hold it in the end, and using the wheel just sharpen up the last quarter of an inch of the screwdriver bit to remove the worn part away. So this is my ER20 collet set, and what I want is a collet that will hold this hexagonal. That's too big. That might do it. I'll try that one, which is a 7mm collet. Take the nut. That fits into there. And that should fit into there. So go back to the tool and cutter grinder and see if I can set up on this angle. So on this tool and cutter grinder here, I have a tray and it's just got oil in. That goes under the wheel and that catches probably half of the grit and dust that comes off the wheel. So it's worth doing, and it stops all those bits of grit going around the workshop. This wheel is a diamond grinding wheel. I could change it for a stone wheel, but it's just not worth it for the amount of grinding I'm going to do. It's only a very small part. So I'll set this up to hold the screwdriver. And this is the collet we chose. And that should hold the screwdriver bit. And I'll put the bit in onto the hex again. Undo this, and this can turn to meet the same angle as a screwdriver bit, which on this one looks like 60 degrees. Okay, I've set the angle of the screwdriver bit, and now I'll turn the wheel on and just go across a few times to see what it's grinding like. Move it closer to the wheel. I'll just grind some more material off. Probably want some taking off the front now, because I've gone that far back that this is probably hitting the hole in the screw. Take that out and see what it looks like. That fits better now. We'll have a look on the microscope and see what that's like. Now this is now the old edge. You see, this looks fairly blunt compared to the new edge I've just put on the end. So we'll cut another. There you can see the new edge, it's taken away all the rounded off part, and I've got quite a sharp corner on there now. So that should grip the screw a lot better. If I compare that to the old one, which was on the other end, you can see how the edge, it's completely gone on that one. So what I'll do is go back to the grinder grind the tip on that first and then redo the edge. I'll reset the angle and we'll grind the outside. Okay, I've reset the angle to 60 degrees and I'll now grind the outside of this screwdriver. See if the screw will hold on that. Wouldn't hold in there before, so I'll take that out now and we'll have a look under the microscope. As I take it out, all I do is undo the collet. Slide it out. On this fixture, the collet holder for ER20, the spindle goes through. On the end of the spindle I've got this dividing ring, so I can turn it round and there's a pin that comes through the side here that goes into either of these holes. Then this here will feed in the part into the wheel. Now it does have some limitations here because it's working in a groove, you've a bit of play in there, so you always must always keep the pressure on the spindle forward. This is just a lock screw, so I've put that on slightly so there's some pressure on, and if the pressure does come off, the locking part there will hold it and stop it pushing back. I've thought, trying to think of some way of putting a dial indicator on here so I can actually see a visual position of how far I've gone in. So if I'm doing a drill or something, I can do each side exactly the same. At the moment I do both sides roughly and then come into the stop and then turn it round doing both sides to get them the same, but it would be nice to know how far you've fed in and out. And then on this part here, it's just a screw that locks the table so you can set the angle, lock it again, and this pin that locks into the dividing ring . Once I put the pin in, that stops it twisting, turning on here, but you can also still move in out. The pin is in an elongated hole, so it will, once it's locked in, you can still move it in and out to put the feed on the
wheel.
And you can see there you can get a good eighth of an inch feed on there which is ample for most sharpening requirements. It's a microscope again, so if I find the edge, there we go, you see I've ground that, I've left actually a bit more, it's not a the edge is sharp but it's still got a weakness on there. You can see on this end of the screwdriver blade I've not removed all the worn parts, it still shows some wear there. Let me see if I can move it round a bit here. The white is the wear on the edge, but it has got a sharp edge on the part. Well, that's a lot more positive than it was. I don't have to put so much pressure on.
Let's try the other end. A lot better.
Well, that saved that screwdriver tip. Well, that's it for today. Hope that was useful, hope it's interesting, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.